In this lecture, we'll be covering component testing, test basis, test objects, and defect failure. Now, test basis is nothing but the requirements. Test objects will tell us what we need to implement our requirements. And finally, we will be focusing on the types of defects or failures that we can find during component testing. First, we have test basis. What are the requirements to do component testing? Number one, we have detailed design. We need this to check if the code has been correctly written. The second requirement is for a data model. What is the valid range and what are the invalid values? This data model will give us the answer. The third is component specification. This refers to specific documents that lay out how the component is implemented and its purpose. The fourth one is code. We need this to run the tests on the components. So we needed four things to do component testing: detailed design, data model, component specification, and code. Now let's move on to test objects. What are the objects involved in component testing? The first object is the component, unit, or module. So if there is a larger software, then we need its smallest unit or module to perform the tests on. The second is code and data structure. The third is classes. If you have any classes defined, for instance, in the C++ programming language, then they are also required for testing. The final one is database module. If there is a range of data that you wish to test, then it falls under database module. So these were the test objects. Now, let's turn our attention to the defects we might find in component testing. First, incorrect functionality. We have a reference document which has the design specifications. If there is a mismatch between the document and the code, we will find it here. Next is data flow problem. During the test, if the data is not flowing as specified in the document, that is a defect. Third is incorrect code logic. If we find that the logic in the design has not been properly implemented in the code, then we have found a defect. Since we are testing the smallest component, these errors in logic are easy to discover. The final one is conditions. Sometimes when writing codes, the developer puts in the wrong if-then condition or a greater than or lesser than sign. These errors are also found during component testing. So these are all the defects you can find when you test individual components. I'll see you in the next video. Happy testing.